Scripture tells us in Luke 12:40, "Be ye therefore ready also, for the Son of Man cometh at an hour when you think not." So what that is saying is be ready all the time, because Jesus will come when we least expect it. He's coming to get his church, y'all. He's coming for the believer. So I'm asking you, what are you going to do when the church is gone? What are you going to do when you find that the Christian that have been praying for you is gone? All Christians will be gone and caught up with Jesus. What are you going to do? What are you going to see in this land? Will you see more hate, more violence than ever before, more evil than you have ever witnessed before? When the church is gone, will the unbelievers see more hate crimes? Will they see more road rage? Will they see more guns in the streets? What you gonna do when the church is gone? Will you say, where are they? Where have they gone? Is it too late? Because now you are seeing more and more school shootings, more smash and grab, more killings with guns, knives, and driving through parades without hesitation, killing people and wounding people. Will you see more gang violence, more sex trafficking, more child pornography? More and more darkness in the world that is an abomination to God. What you gonna do when the church is gone, when no one is praying for you, and you begin to see more wickedness, more evil in the land? What you gonna do? The evil eye is upon you, and there's nowhere to run and nowhere to hide. Is this how you want it to be for you? Because this is how it will be for you. Because 1 Thessalonians 4:16 says, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the thump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first." And then 1 Thessalonians 4:17 says, "We which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord." Revelation 3:10, it reads, Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, the Lord says, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. The Living Bible paraphrase says it this way. The Lord says, because you have patiently obeyed me despite the persecution, therefore I will protect you from the time of great tribulation and temptation. Listen to that again. He said, I will protect you from the time of great tribulation and temptation, which will come upon the world to test everyone alive. Look, it says, I am coming soon. Hold tightly to the little strength you have, so that no one will take away your crown. Listen, when the church is gone, what will you do? because the church is no longer here praying for you. All you are doing is being exposed to the evils that is left here in the world before God punished them all. So I say to you today, repent now. Turn from your wicked ways before it's too late. Before you find yourself saying, where is everybody? Where is the church? I can't find them. Is it too late? Now, I don't own the rights to the music or the graphics, but I thank God for them. I'm Minister Sharon Ford of Spiritual Care of Southfield. May God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, be with you until we meet again. Amen.
What you gonna do when the church is gone? What you gonna do?